Hello students, today we will learn our next topic, that is positive, negative and zero acceleration. An object can have positive or negative acceleration. When the velocity of an object increases, the acceleration is positive. When the velocity of an object, they said increase, that time the acceleration is positive. In this case, the acceleration is in the direction of velocity. When there is a positive acceleration, that time acceleration is in the direction of velocity. When the velocity of an object decreases with time, it has negative acceleration. Sometimes in object, the velocity is decreases with the time, and that is called negative acceleration. Negative acceleration is also called deceleration. Its direction is opposite to the direction of velocity. When there is an acceleration occur, that is, its direction is opposite to the velocity. And if the velocity of the object does not change with time, it has zero acceleration. Means for the object that does not change its velocity, and that is called zero acceleration. Next point we have given distance time graph for uniform motion. The following table shows the distance covered by a car in fixed time intervals. Draw a graph of distance against time, taking time along the x-axis, here we have given already that, and distance along the y-axis. Distance along the y-axis. And by this information, we have to draw graph. We have already seen that uniform motion, and like this straight line graph we get there. An object in uniform motion covers equal distances in equal time intervals, thus the graph between distance and time is a straight line. And we get distance time graph for uniform motion is like this in straight line. Next, that we have given distance time graph for non-uniform motion. The following table shows the distances covered by a bus in equal time intervals. Draw a graph of distance against time, taking the time along the x-axis and distance along the y-axis. Figure we have given, that is 1.6. Does the graph show a direct proportionality between the distance and time? Related to this, you have to draw graph. And how the graph you can get, that you have to show me. We have already learned non-uniform motion. So here also we get the graph that is not in straight line. So like this zigzag in motion, we get that graph. It means from this example, we understand that here the distance changes non-uniformly with time. Thus, the bus is having non-uniform motion. Means bus travel unequal distances in equal times intervals. So that is we from that we get the non-uniform motion graph here.